Turning static images into dynamic videos with smooth camera movements is getting easier thanks to the latest feature from Runway, camera control. Now available for Runway Gen 3 Alpha Turbo, but is it really that good? In today's video, we're diving into Runway's camera control feature, so stick around till the end. You don't want to miss out on this. Alright, let's jump right in and test out Runway camera control. Just go to runwayml.com, click on Generative Video, and make sure you are using Gen 3 Alpha Turbo, and then click on the camera control icon on the left nav bar. After that, just import the photo or image you want to animate. First, I tried to make the three-point camera move horizontally to the left and pan the three points slightly to the right. Or you can also click directly on the close-up orbit left option below for a shortcut. And this time we try it without additional prompts. Then just click generate and we will see what the results are like. Let's just skip the generating process and this is the result. Runway does produce good image quality. The camera movement is also appropriate, but in my opinion, this still looks very AI. The movement of the subject is not natural and not dynamic enough. Well, let's try generating again. And this time we'll use the close-up orbit right. And again, without any additional prompts at all. I just skipped the generating process and this is the result. Same as before, the movement is according to the camera control, but the subject movement is not dynamic at all. Okay, now it's time to add a prompt. So I want the subject woman walking slowly and the wind blowing softly on her hair. And for the camera movement, zoom out and pan a little. And this is the result. The camera zooms out, but the panning doesn't appear. Even the subject doesn't move. The hair isn't exposed to the wind like the prompt I wrote. That's the downside of Runway. The image to video movement is still a bit difficult to make dynamic. But I have to admit, the image quality is really great. Alright, before we try again, we better read up a bit first on the Runway camera control guide. The link is in the description. As for the price, with camera control, it costs 5 credits per second, which I'd say is quite expensive for the results you get. But if you use the unlimited plan, it's definitely more worth it, since we can try as many times as we want for trial and error. If you scroll down on this guide page, there are examples too, and from these examples, the movement looks pretty dynamic. But when you try it yourself, well, you get results like what we saw earlier. It takes trial and error and multiple attempts to get results that match your expectations. For more details, you guys can read directly on the guide page and try practicing it yourself to understand it better. Anyway, now we're going to try animating objects. And this time I'm going to try animating a pair of shoes. Let's go ahead and upload the image and I'll use several camera movements at once. I'll explain them one by one when we review the results later. Alright everyone, it's time for us to review the results. For the first video, I made the camera orbit and pan to the right. Yes, it worked as intended, but the problem is there's an extra thread string that appeared above. For the next result, I also made it orbit and pan to the left, and this seems to be the closest to what I expected. Although there's almost a thread appearing, it's not significant, and this result is okay. And for the next result, I only used the zoom in camera movement, but this is what happened. The shoes actually changed position. This is a fail because I expected only the camera to move. Plus, that thread appeared again. For the last one, I tried using more complex camera movement where the camera moves vertically upward while zooming out and then tilts down, and this is the result. It's actually amazing that the camera movement worked as intended, but once again that thread still appears. So that's the video for today. If you think Runway's camera control feature is worth trying, go ahead and try it yourself. And if you like content like this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe so you won't miss the latest updates about AI. See you in the next video.